Welcome to the fourth installment of the Teach Me CQL series. This series is presented by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. It is intended to support healthcare quality leaders, health IT vendors, and measure developers explore the use of CQL, or clinical quality language. In today's segment, we will discuss the use of the Coalesce function native to CQL. As we have done in our previous sessions, we will use current eCQM logic examples to illustrate the lesson. In our previous sessions, we have discussed CQL functions in the global common library, like normalize interval and latest of. These functions use CQL to create functions that are shared across eCQMs using the global common library. Today, we will be talking about a native operator to CQL that can be referenced in the HL7 CQL specification. CQL is an HL7 standard that defines a representation for the expression of clinical knowledge that can be used within both the clinical decision support and clinical quality measurement domains. The landing page for the CQL specification provides a blue navigation bar that lists chapters within the specification, like author's guide and CQL reference. The author's guide introduces the high-level syntax for the CQL focused on measure and decision support authors. The developer's guide complements the author's guide by providing more in-depth discussion of language elements, semantics, and more complex query scenarios, and more advanced topics such as typing and function definition. For today's lesson, we will look in the developer's guide and scroll down to section 6, nullological operators. Let's learn a little bit about the Coalesce operator before we review our measure example. In the CQL specification, the Coalesce operator is defined as follows. To return the first non-null expression among two or more expressions, use the Coalesce operator. And we see here the Coalesce statement includes X, Y, and Z, which is equivalent to the case when X is not null, then X, when Y is not null, then Y, or else Z, and then end. Stated another way, the Coalesce operator asks the computer to look through a set of expressions and return the first one that has a value that is not a null value. Let's take a look at a measure example to help bring this expression to life. For our measure example today, we will be using CMS 145, coronary artery disease, beta blocker therapy prior myocardial infarction, or left ventricular systolic dysfunction. This measure looks for percentage of patients age 18 years and older with a diagnosis of coronary artery disease within a 12-month period who also have a prior myocardial infarction or a current or prior left ventricular ejection fraction who were prescribed beta blocker therapy. If we look at the definition, qualifying CAD encounter and history of moderate or severe LVSD, we will see the use of the Coalesce operator there. In this definition statement, the Coalesce operator is helping to find the first non-null date-time value associated with the LVSD findings, whether that data is collected using a date-time or a period. You now have a better understanding of the Coalesce operator and how it behaves with measure data types. We hope you have enjoyed this series on CQL functions and the Global Common Library. If you have further CQL questions or need technical assistance, please visit the ONC JIRA CQL Issue Tracker.